If the IS-4 taught us anything, it is that sometimes the biggest threat to a tank isn't the enemy, but the people who design it. In this video, you will get to know one of the reasons why heavy tanks don't exist anymore. The Soviet IS-4 tank. Big, slow, louder than a jet engine, expensive and unreliable. It was so bad it contributed to the idea of never ever creating something like this again. Alright, wait. Let's take this slowly and maybe with a little bit less bias. So, the IS-4 heavy tank, aka Object 701, during the prototype stage, was created during the end of World War II when the Soviet Union was looking to upgrade its tanks after dealing with German tanks like the Tiger and Panther. In 1943, Soviet engineers at the SKB-2 Bureau in the famous Chelyabinsk Kirov Plant started designing this new heavy tank. The goal was to replace the IS-2, an arguably perfectly working tank with something that had better armor and more firepower to make it strong enough to handle the strong 88mm guns used by the Germans. Well, technically the Object 701 did what it was made for, but the negatives were just so much that the tank itself doesn't even exist anymore. Anyways, they decided to equip the new Object 701 with the same 122mm D25T gun used on the IS-2, and make sure it had solid armor all around, which eventually turned it into one of the heaviest and most powerful tanks of that time. And this heavy piece of Stalinum is what we're gonna talk about today. So hello and welcome and enjoy this video. The Object 701 was developed step by step with 6 different prototypes being made, each one improving things like armor thickness, turret design and the inside layout. By 1945, the final version was strong enough to take direct hits from the German 88mm L-71 gun. But guess what? The war ended that year. So perfect timing. And regardless, as World War II was ending, the Soviet Union instead decided to go with the IS-3, which was a lighter and faster heavy tank. So, the Object 701 project was put on hold. It's a sad start for the Object 701, not gonna lie. However, the IS-3 ended up having some unexpected problems with its new design, which affected its reliability. Because of this, the Soviet military decided to bring back the Object 701 project, and in April 1946, it was officially approved as the IS-4. Production of the IS-4 started in 1947. It was a giant, almost 10 meters long and over 3 meters wide, and weighed a massive 59 metric tons, which, if you're wondering, is approximately the weight of 1,000 bad ideas put in one place. The hull had a 140mm thick front glacis angled at 61 degrees, and the 160mm lower plate sloped at 40 degrees, which, yeah, can stop some projectiles. The armor design covered the whole tank with the sides protected by 160mm of armor angled at 30 degrees to help deflect incoming shots. The turret was also a beast, with 250mm thick armor at the front that tapered to 200mm at the sides. Now, just for you to understand how much this actually is. The IS-4's side armor was as thick as the front of the German Tiger II. Inside this massive tank was a V12-12M diesel engine which gave the IS-4 750 horsepower and allowed it to hit speeds of 43 km an hour on a good day. Now but seriously, this was pretty alright considering how heavy it was. The engine design was inspired by captured German tanks like the Panther and Tiger and used a dual fan radiator system to keep it cool. This powerful engine gave the IS-4 enough torque to move all that weight, but it guzzled fuel, which meant its range was limited to about 170 km or 105 miles. Also, it needed a lot of maintenance, adding to the challenge of keeping it run smoothly. The IS-4 used a torsion bar suspension system with 7 pairs of road wheels to spread out its weight. Instead of shock absorbers, which might not hold up, engineers added heavy-duty bump stops to handle the stress on the suspension. The tank had a crew of 4, a commander, driver, loader and gunner. The driver was at the front of the hull while the others worked in the turret. Their main weapon was the D25T, a 122mm gun made to destroy enemy tanks and strongholds. They also had two DSHKM 12.7mm machine guns, one mounted coaxially next to the main gun, and one on the loader's hatch for shooting at aircraft. Now, all of this sounds great, but in reality the IS-4's design ran into a lot of problems. Even though it was planned for large-scale production, issues came up right away. The tank was expensive to build and costed almost ₹1 million per unit. In comparison, one IS-2 from the 1940s cost about ₹260,000. So the only thing the IS-4 really destroyed was the Soviet budget. Also, its mechanical parts were unreliable. The transmission was especially problematic and broke down a lot during long drives and needed replacements after only a few hundred kilometers. Quality control at the factory was also an issue, with around 60% of tanks being rejected initially due to poor construction. By the time production stopped in 1949, only about 233 units were made, and the final upgraded version, the IS-4M, came out in 1951. The IS-4M was an attempt to fix the IS-4's problems. It got an upgraded transmission, a stronger engine, and an anti-aircraft machine gun mounted on top of the turret. Ventilation and ammo storages were improved to make things a bit easier and more comfortable for the crew. They also added a new side skirt and track cover to cut down on dust and debris, which helped it perform better off-road. Revolutionary stuff, if you don't mind that it was still too heavy to cross most bridges or fit on a train. Even with these improvements, the IS-4M didn't really make the tank much more useful. The IS-4 didn't see much action in the field either. It had great armor protection but was very heavy because of that, so it was a pain to move around because it was too heavy for most trains and bridges. With a range of only 170 km, its mobility was limited by how much fuel it burned, so often it needed extra fuel tanks for longer missions. Consequently, the Soviet military didn't find many chances to use the IS-4 effectively in Europe. Instead, they stationed most of them in the Soviet Far East. There, the tanks were mostly used as stationary defenses, with some even being turned into pillboxes along the Chinese border. As the Cold War intensified, the idea of using heavy tanks like the IS-4 became outdated. By the early 1960s, the Soviet had shifted to lighter and more reliable tanks like the T-10, which, being lighter, were much easier to move around. The IS-4's thick armor, which was once impressive, started to feel less useful as anti-tank weapons got better. New types of rounds and warheads could now punch through thick plating. So, Soviet commanders eventually stopped using the IS-4 in active service and instead used them for training or putting them in reserve. Today, only a few IS-4 tanks are still around. Out of the small number produced, just 3 have been saved as museum displays. 3. Like someone really thought they should preserve them for future generations to laugh at. One stands at the Kubinka Tank Museum near Moscow, another in the Army Officers' House Park in Chita, which is in Russia, and a third at the Military Equipment Alley in Semey, Kazakhstan. The IS-4 is also playable in a few video games like World of Tanks and War Thunder, quite frankly, as you can see here. Anyways, thanks for watching this video about tank history's least proud moment, and remember, stay out of tanks that make your washing machine look reliable.
Target destroyed!